Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In this video, we will learn how to send data from an ESP32 to Google Sheets using both the Arduino IDE and MicroPython. We will be using the DHT22 sensor to gather temperature and humidity data, which we will send directly to Google Sheet for easy monitoring and logging. We will be using Wokwi to simulate our circuit. If you would like to know more about Wokwi, you can watch my previous videos. In this video, we will look at three scenarios. The first scenario will be ESP32 updating data in the Google Sheet. And the second scenario will be ESP32 replacing the data in the Google Sheet. And the third scenario will be sending the data to the Google Sheet on a button press. So let's get started with the setup of Google Sheet. So the first thing that we have to do is open a blank spreadsheet, and we can rename this spreadsheet to ESP32 data. And then we will have to go to extensions and in the app script. And here you can add a function to receive the data and parse. So I will remove this function and I will post this following function. So this function will handle the data coming from the ESP32. This function is called doPost with a parameter E. It is triggered when the ESP32 sends data to the Google Sheet through a post request, which is a part of HTTP protocol. Now let's understand what we are doing in this function. First, we access the Google Sheet by using this line. This ensures that we are working with the currently active sheet. Next, we take the data that comes in as part of the post request and we parse it using this line. This allows us to handle the incoming temperature, humidity, button state, and timestamp value as variables. Then we check if the method in the incoming data is append. If so, we append a new row to the Google Sheet using sheet.appendRow. Here we add the current time retrieved with new date, the ESP32 timestamp, which we will get from the NTP, and the temperature, humidity, and the state of the button. This logs new entries without removing any previous data. On the other hand, for the second scenario, we are using a method called replace. This function first clears all the existing data in the sheet using sheet.clear. After that, it adds a new header row with labels like sheet time, ESP32 time, temperature, humidity, and button state. Then it appends the new data just like in the append method. Finally, the function returns a response with the message data received successfully to confirm that the data has been sent and processed. Now we have to deploy this function. We will click on new deployment and then we will click here on the setting button and we will click on web app, and here we can give a description and who has access. I will change it to anyone and then I will click on deploy. Once deployed, you have to authorize access. Click on your account, go on advanced and click here, go to this project, click on allow, and this is the URL that we will need in order to send the data. Click on done. And you can also change the name here as well, ESP32 data, like this. So now we are done. Now we can go back to our Google Sheet and let's set it up. For example, let's say here we will get time. Here we will get time from ESP32. And here we will get temperature. Here we'll get humidity. And here we will get button state. Here we can write DHT data and we can merge all these rows and we can change the background to orange and change the alignment to center so it looks good, and we can make these all bold. So now we are ready. Now let's go to Wokwi and send data from ESP32. So now let's create our circuit and simulate it. So I'm here on Wokwi. If you would like to know more about Wokwi, you can watch my previous videos, and I have also make a video where I have used Wokwi in VS Code. You can watch that as well. So here I will select ESP32 and I'll go to my projects and I'll click on new project. And here I will select ESP32. First, we will start with Arduino. So I will click here on Arduino. We have our ESP32 and we can write our code here. So I will quickly make a circuit. So let's say I will need a DHT22. I'll click here, and this is our DHT22. I will quickly connect it. So the ground will go to the ground pin of ESP. SDA, we can connect it to any digital pin. We are connecting it to pin 4. And the VCC, it should go to the 5 volt here. And now I will add buttons. We need two push buttons. So the first pin will go to the ground, and the another pin, we can connect it to pin number 16, and we will get another push button. One push button to show the state of the button, and one for sending the data. So this first pin will go to the ground, and the another pin, we can connect it to pin number 2. So I can change the colors of these pins. This should be black because it is going to ground. So our circuit is ready, and I will remove all this code. We do not need this. And now I'll go to library manager, and I will add few libraries here. DHT sensor library, NTP client, and DHT for ESP, and I'll come here in the sketch, and I will use this code. So we first start by including the libraries. We have all these libraries: Wi-Fi, HTTP client, NTP client, and DHT. We are using the HTTP client to send the POST request that we will send to the Google Sheet, and then we are defining our DHT pin 4 here, and we are defining the type of DHT, which is DHT22 sensor, and then we are creating an object, and then here we have button pins. We are defining the button pins. We have the send pin at pin number 2 and the state pin at 16, and then we will define the SSID and password. So SSID, if you are using it on your ESP32, you can enter the SSID and password of your Wi-Fi. Otherwise, if you are using Wokwi, you can simply write Wokwi guest here, and the password is empty for Wokwi. And in the URL, we will paste the URL that we got from here. We will need this URL, and we will paste it here like this. Then we are initializing the Wi-Fi and NTP client here. So for now, the NTP will send the UTC values, which is GMT0. And then in the setup function, we are first defining the baud rate for the serial communication to show the serial values. And then we are initializing our Wi-Fi, and until we are not connected to the Wi-Fi, it will print connecting to Wi-Fi. But once it is connected, it will print connected to the Wi-Fi. And then we start the DHT sensor, and then we initialize the NTP client. And then we are defining our buttons as input, and we are using the internal pull up configuration. Then in the loop function, we are first reading the button state. So this line reads the state of button, either the button is pressed or not. Then if Wi-Fi status, this checks if we are connected to the Wi-Fi. This line initializes an HTTP client, and http.begin server name opens the connection to the Google Apps script URL, because we have defined server name. We have set the server name to the URL that we got from the Google spreadsheet. Then we are getting the time, formatted time, from the NTP client, and then we are reading the values from the DHT sensor, and then we are creating a JSON data, and here we are using the append method for now, but we will see in the next case when we will use the replace method. And we are setting the temperature to temperature, humidity to the value of humidity, timestamp to the formatted time that we are getting from the NTP client, and the button state we are getting it from here. And then we will simply post our JSON data, and this will get the response code. So these are the HTTP response codes, like the 200 for successful, 404 for not found, and you can read more about that on internet. And here we are checking if our response was successful, then we are printing the response, and finally we are ending the connection. So now let's run this. If you are using Wokwi on browser, sometimes it takes a lot of time. So for those cases, you can use Wokwi in a VS Code, which I have explained in one of my previous videos, and using Wokwi in VS Code is much faster than using it in the browser. Currently, we are sending data after every 5 seconds, but you can change this delay value if you want to send data more frequently or less frequently. So now we are connected to the Wi-Fi. We should receive values, and you see we have received the value here. And this ESP32 time, this is in the UTC, but you can change it to your current time, whichever you want. And now let's press this button. So now you see the button state is true as well, and this will go on. So if you want to change this UTC time, you can go back to the code, and here where we have defined the NTP client, here you can tell here, for example, for GMT2 you can write 7200, which means we are defining 2 hours in seconds. So there are 7200 seconds in 2 hours, so this will define the GMT+2. So now you can see the time here matches with the time in the Google sheet. So that's how you can change the time. And let's try to change temperature and humidity values, and you can see the values of temperature and humidity has changed here. So now let's see how, if we want to replace our data instead of appending, how we can do that. So to do that, you will have to go here in the JSON data, and in the method you will have to change append to replace, and let's rerun it. We are connected to Wi-Fi, and now it should replace the data, and you can see that everything has been removed and it has replaced the data. And this is because we have defined the, we have added this headers here in the this function, so we are getting this header. So this will keep replacing these values. So now let's say if you want to send the data on a button press, how you can do that. So I'll go back to the code. So I will uncomment this line. So this is if digital read button send pin is equal to low, since we are using the pull up configuration. So when we will press the button, the state of the button will be low, then only then we will read the data, and only then we will send the data. So I will remove this, and now I can change this delay to something lower, like 100. So now let's run this code, and I will open this sheet side by side. One more thing that we have to change here is we have to change the method from replace to append. And now we will run our code again. So now if we will press button here, we should get our data here. And you see we are getting data here. Now let's do the same in the MicroPython. So I clicked on a new project. I will go to ESP32 and I'll go to MicroPython. And in the diagram.json, I will copy this diagram there, and I will paste it here. And this is the same circuit, and in the main.py I can remove this. In the main.py I will use the following code. Let me quickly give you an introduction to this code. So we are first importing the libraries. So we are have the network library, machine library to access the GPIOs, time library for delays, NTP for the time, and UR request for the HTTP request. So here we are defining our DHT sensor pin number 4 and DHT22, and here we are defining the NTP server, and there here we are defining our buttons, so pin number 2 and that is input, and we are using the internal pull up. And then here we define the SSID and the password of our Wokwi, but you can change it depending on your code. And this is the URL that we have here. If I go to manage deployments, so this is this URL. I will paste it here. And then this is the function to connect to the Wi-Fi, and unless we are not connected, it will print connecting to the Wi-Fi, and this function help us get the NTP time. And then this is the main function where we send the data. We first read the sensor humidity and temperature, and then we read the value of the button state, and then we get the time, and then we create a JSON data. And here we have the method equal to append. You can change it to replace if you want to replace the values. And then here we are writing the temperature, humidity and timestamp values. And here under the try and accept block, we are sending the we are posting the data and we are getting the response. And here we are printing the response. In case of error, we are printing the error. And in the main loop, there is a condition that if we are pressing the button, then send data. So now let's try this code. So I will open here this, and now let's run this. It is a bit faster than building the Arduino IDE code, and we are connected to the Wi-Fi. So now let's press the button, and we received the value here. So now let's change a bit of temperature, and now let's send it again, and we received the new temperature value here. But if you would like to send without button press, you can come back to the code and you can remove this line, and we have to remove the indentation from here, and we have to simply run this. Now let's run it again. So we have our data here. So now let's change the value of humidity as well, and we got the new data here. But and if you would like to replace the data, you can go back to the code, and here in the data format, you can simply replace this with replace and run it again. So now the sheet should be cleared and a new data should be added. So you see everything is removed and we have got this. In the end, I would like to mention about my book, which is available on Amazon. If you're interested to learn more about ESP32 and build exciting IoT projects, check out this book. And finally, if you like this video, please like and share. If you have any question, feel free to write them in the comments, and subscribe and share for more such videos.